Hello, everyone. Today I will be shredding some school assignments. Those assignments I'm going to be shredding are my assignments and one of my friend's assignments. One of my friends actually wants me to show him how easily that my shredder can shred braille paper and what the shreds feel like and how well it handles it and stuff like that. So we're going to be, I'm going to be shredding all my assignments. My assignments are mixed in with his assignments. I tried doing this before, however, we forgot to empty the bin, and during shredding, it just stopped working, and then we realized that the bin was full, so we emptied it, but it's all empty now, so we're good to shred. So, I have a big beast of a shredder over here. This is the Fellows Power Shred 79CI Shredder. It'll take 16 sheets at a time, and it'll take like 5 or 6 sheets of braille. Now, because of the size of the opening is way too small, so I'm gonna have to fold some of the stuff in half, but it'll still take it in with ease. I expect it's going to have to power through a lot of it. I suspect there's gonna be a lot of misfeeds. I'm gonna overfeed it a lot, and but the shredder's just gonna have a wonderful time. Since this wicked witch can power through this stuff all day, it's it really helps me when I'm trying to get through a lot of shredding because I know it won't jam. So we're gonna start shredding, and I'll talk to you as we shred. So here we go. So one of the things that I like to do in a wood shop is shred paper. Now my wood shop teacher actually has a Fellows Power Shred 84CI rather. It's pretty much the same as this one.
It has the same exact
motor and everything. I don't like it because it has a touchscreen, so no matter what I do, I always activate the touchscreen, and I shut it off, and that's why I went with this one. This one's pretty much the exact same shredder. And another thing I noticed, that even though the 84CI is 100% jam-proof, I noticed that it was still jammed sometimes, even though it tried to power through it, so I had to literally rip the paper back out. Perhaps Fellows may have had some issues with that sensor earlier, and just then they just came out with they just kind of improved the shredder performance, and okay, that's way too much for it. Learned my lesson there, but I know that a lot of people, I know Fellows really likes to get into a lot of cool, hang on, it'll do it, it knows what it's doing. There you go! There's our first power through of the day here. What was I saying? I know Fellows is trying to get into a lot of cool innovations with the shredders and other office supplies and whatnot, but I find that touchscreen is a little bit, you know, harder to work with. But no matter what you do, it always does something that you don't want it to do. And, you know, I don't think touchscreen is really good for, you know, the visually impaired. But, I guess now what I'll talk to you is about why I chose this shredder. So, I used to use my mother's old cheapo 5-sheet shredder, which was made by Concept Solutions, and I like shredding. I do a lot of shredding at home, like whenever I get the chance to. That's why I do it in wood shop. And I was shredding for one of my mother's friends who runs a business, and she had a lot of, like, a stockpile of documents she was trying to get rid of. And what ended up happening was I'd have to count the amount of sheets I fed through the shredder. So what would happen is I thought this was gonna misfeed. I bet it is. But I took like three sheets, and one of them was like folded over, and then it just had a hard time. It actually jammed. And I had to go forward, reverse, forward, reverse, just not a good time, and it overheated. I was worried that it was actually going to start a fire. Well, not literally start a fire, but overheat quickly, you know, because the motor is really working hard. Oh, I wonder if this will do this. Okay, no, it won't. Let's try this thing. Okay. It'll do it. It knows what it's doing. Hang on. There you go. See, it just has to pause, reverse out paper, and power right through it. No nonsense with ripping all the paper back out. If I overfeed it, it won't take it in. Just need to wait for this to go down. And, so then I started, doing some research on different shredders. Hang on. And I found out that, they had, shredders with, jam prevention capabilities and, all that cool bells and whistles. And I thought, hey, you know what? That might actually be useful. So, What I ended up doing back in April was I was researching on shredders, and I came across one called the Fellows Power Shred 99CI, and it was pretty good. It was a 17-sheet shredder, and it had a 9-gallon pull-out waste bin, and this is really having a little bit of a hard time, but it'll do it. I wonder if the bin is full. Oh yeah, the bin is full. But anyways, I'll show you what those shreds look like right now. And for you, my fine young friend, I'll try to describe what the shreds feel like. They're very small. Get a close-up. You can see them all right. But I cannot read a single thing on those shreds. I still have quite a bit more, but anyways, I came across one of those Power Shred 799CI. I wonder if I could get another sheet through there. There we go. And it was too expensive. It was like $500. And my mother didn't really like that, so I started doing some research on the 79CI. Now, the model I came across with the 79CI was like a 14-sheet shredder, and I thought, you know what? That might actually be pretty good. Then I realized that they had updated it, and now it's a 16-sheet shredder. So, and then I tried to do some shopping. I looked at other companies, different brands, and what they had to offer, like Swingline with their Stack and Shred series. And then I realized, no, I don't want that. The Stack and Shred series is good, but it kind of ruins the whole hands-on experience, so I just went with this one. This one I found on sale for like $300. The original price was like $400, and it didn't come with a box, it didn't come with an owner's manual, but I said, hey, you know what, let's pick it up anyway. I think this is actually going to be good for shredding. So I just picked it up, and I've been really happy with it ever since. So I'm definitely going to keep it. I definitely think it's totally worth it. I know it's pretty expensive though, but in the end, it handles braille paper just fine, and like I said, I cannot read a single thing on those shreds. So, anyways, that is it. I still have a crap ton of stuff to get rid of, but I'll do that when this video is probably uploading. Darren, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you guys for watching, and goodbye for now.